In this video, we're going to share with you a brand new function here inside EasyStone version 3 beta release 8, a function that we have been working on quite literally for weeks to perfect. And it was really important function to have because it's something that we use all the time when we're doing our design work. And this is just an example of how we would utilize this function. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to create this design, but I want to use different stone sizes to do it and have a more artistic flair to this text. And so that's what we're going to show you, how we're going to do that here using this new function. So what we're going to do here is come into our stone tab, and we're going to choose, we'll start with our SS16 stone. So I have nothing selected. I'm just going to click on this button and hit drop stone, and this will drop an SS16 stone just like so. All right. And then what we're going to do is just copy this in various locations throughout the design where I think I want this. So let me just show you. We'll just hit the space bar wherever we think we want these stones. And I don't pay too much attention to the original layout, but so you can see there's really, as of right now, we're just slapping some stones in. We're not overly concerned about equal spacing, how many stones. You can overlap them like that. We're just kind of what I would call slapping some stones in. And I'll just take a step back and look at where else I may want a couple of big stones. And we can always change our mind too. You know, this isn't written in stone. But I just want to give you a better idea of how I sometimes go about creating designs that have a bit more artistic flair to them. All right, and we'll do the same thing here, I guess. So we're just copying it down, holding them, selecting them both, shift add stones, that fills in the gap. And I don't know, maybe we'll put a couple here. Maybe we won't keep them, maybe we will. So one at the top of the K, one at the bottom. Select them both, shift add stones, that fills in between. Switch that out to a 10. So we'll have that to a 10, and then we'll come down here. And all I'm doing is dragging with my left mouse and then right clicking. Let's change that out to a 6, and we'll change this out to a 6. Something like so, maybe. Again, really no rhyme or reason to what we're doing. We're just whatever we're feeling at the moment. And, you know, you don't have to pay too much attention to the original design. You know, you can waver from that. So now what are we going to do here with the rock? Well, we're going to grab an SS16 stone, and we're going to start placing these where we want them. So I'm just hitting the space bar. I want this to go up here. I want this to come around like so. We put one or two there. Let's put three or four there. Then we'll come down and we'll just okay, that's good. So you can see it's been just kind of, at the beginning, it's a bit haphazard what we're doing as far as stone placements go. But we're just kind of blocking some things in here. Switch those out to 10s there. All right, so now what we're going to do is kind of go back through and fine-tune some things. So let's make those 10s. And we're just going to kind of fill in these gaps as best we can. And then we're going to show you the magic. So far, this is just leading up to the magic. So we're just, again, we just slap some stones in here. Very, very simple technique. And at the end of the day, no software program is gonna calculate all this for you. So you do have to get used to working with programs and allowing you to be a little bit creative in the type of thing that we do. All right. So the next one, we're going to switch those out to sixes. All right. So now we have pretty much, I guess we do need to fill in a little bit here. Make that a 10. So we'll go ahead and fill in some of these gaps that we have. Switch those out to sixes. And the magic is coming, folks. We just got to get there. So let's put those to tens, maybe. And I'll make that a big one as well. Let's put all these to tens. And all I'm doing is hitting my space bar as I'm placing them. Okay, so a couple more here. There we go. All right, so that pretty well gets everything blocked in. Now the magic. Where's the magic going to come into play here? Well, when we delete our text here, we can kind of see better. Maybe I'm going to actually switch those out to tens. They are tens. All right. So let's take a look at what we have. Honestly, it doesn't look too bad, but it's going to look a whole lot better here in a moment. Because we're going to kind of fine-tune and finesse this design. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to just draw a curve from what I would call anchor point to anchor point. Now, as we look at these stones, while it doesn't look bad, as we look at these stones, you can see that the spacing between these stones isn't exactly precise. But we have a new function here on the editing tab where if we hold down our shift key and hit respace, watch what happens. Look at that, perfect spacing between stones. Now it's a bit tight, so what we're gonna do is delete one stone and then do it again. Shift, respace. So now you have nice distribution of stones with a perfect spacing between them. So we have a similar issue here where we have this big sweeping line of stones. So what we're gonna do is we're just going to grab our three-point curve tool and create a curve, just like so. You see that? And then shift, respace again. And you can see nice, even distribution of the stones, so we can delete that path. We no longer need it. So basically, we would just continue on that exact same way. Okay, so go ahead and grab our three-point curve tool. Create our curve the way we want it to right there. Shift, respace. Sort those stones very nicely along that curve. Give us a nice equal distribution. Same thing here. You can see how these stones are just kind of slapped in there. Well, not anymore. We're going to just finesse them very simply. Just like so, shift, respace, and you can see the dramatic difference there in how nice those stones flow. And that's the whole process. So we just kind of go through that all the way through the design, creating these little curves and shift respace. That'll sort those stones out along that path. And so now you can see what we have here. Our R is nicely distributed. So again, we'll do the same thing here. We'll just space this out. Shift respace and delete. And then what we're going to do is grab our selection tool here and select our C here, and we'll just make a couple of changes here. Just move over our O and a C here, and we'll put a little connecting stone there. We'll do the same kind of thing here, a little connecting stone. There we go, there's our C. K actually looks pretty good as is, although this is a little bit wonky, so we'll go ahead and we will shift, respace those a bit. And then here for our S, we will come in here. Little curves, and you can see how we don't even have to get it perfect. Just throw something together here, because it'll kind of set it up all by itself. Maybe a little short segments, bigger segments. Once you get comfortable with this tool, you'll know exactly how best to use it. Okay, when you have situations like that, no problem. Just go in and fix it. We could just delete that node. That's the easiest way to fix that one. All right, so now we have this path. So we'll select our path, shift respace. It'll just reset all those stones for us along the path. And that's it. So now we have a nice even distribution there. And honestly, I think the rest of it's pretty good. So we'll go ahead and select the whole thing, choose add watermark, and now you can see we have a great looking rock star design utilizing that new respace option. And that is when you're dealing with the multiple size stones, is when you want to use the shift respace option. And it gives you a nice distribution of those multiple size stones. I do see a little right there, a little tight curve, but yeah, definitely very good looking design, very easy to put together with the use of that new shift respace function here inside EasyStone.